what's up guys? Welcome back to the Blackout mode. In this video today, we're playing a brand new game mode that was just added to Blackout called Fast Collapse. I was pretty shocked to see them add a limited time event inside of a limited experience beta, which was very, very strange. But either way, here's some gameplay of that. And do we end up getting the victory? You might want to stay to the end to check that out. So what is Fast Collapse? This mode basically allows the Nova Gas Circle or the Nightmare Circle to shrink a lot faster, 2 times the speed than in a normal mode. This means you have less time to explore, less time to scavenge, less time to find weaponry, and of course, less time before you get into fights with enemies. Because the circle shrinks so quickly, people are always constantly on the move, which means you can either get taken off guard or take enemies off guard that may not see you coming. Now, unfortunately, in this game, we started as a quad team, and then one of our random teammates ended up shooting my partner. My partner fired back, and then there was like a big gunfight, and we just lost two of our teammates in the beginning. If you were one of those two gentlemen that ended up getting killed, I apologize. I don't really know what happened, but press F to pay respects. Let's let them know that in the comments section. The other thing that genuinely surprised me about this situation was Treyarch actually let us know that there are 2 other limited time event modes that they're going to be testing throughout this play session. And I really like the idea of sprinkling those in and kind of getting some feedback from us as a community. Speaking of which, our community has been very vocal about the armor, and I think this is the 3rd day in a row I've talked about the armor, but we actually have some feedback from Treyarch themselves about what they plan on doing with the level 2 and level 3 armor. Just a recap for those of you that are not aware, level 2 armor, I believe, deflects 50% damage from bullets coming to your chest, but it will not protect you from a headshot. Your head is wide open. As for level 3 armor, it deflects 65% damage from bullets, and you get protection to your head as well. Now, okay, that sounds pretty crazy, but is it? Yeah, it kinda is. It's a little bit crazy, especially if you're set up with 200 health from your trauma kit and tier 3 armor. At the end of the game, you're basically going to survive anything that's thrown at you. And I think that's why I like the Fast Collapse mode a lot better than the standard mode as of right now, because there really isn't too much armor scattered around and you rarely see people with level 3. And when you do, there's more than just your team shooting at their team. So either way, the armor definitely does need to be tweaked in some way. Level 1 just doesn't really seem to give you that much protection. But when you look at level 1 armor, for example, it just seems fine. Like, it protects you from a few bullets or a few shots, but it doesn't do anything too crazy. But anyway, Treyarch has officially commented on this, by the way. So they said, as with the multiplayer beta, we're taking a cautious approach to changes to armor during the Blackout beta as we keep an eye on overall gameplay balance. As part of a secondary update that recently went live yesterday, we fixed a bug where all explosive damage was not impacting level 3 armor. We are currently evaluating and testing where and how often level 3 armor makes its appearance, as well as reducing its absorption properties, will transfer more damage and break easier. In doing so, we are also evaluating level 2 armor to adjust appropriately. So this is extremely good news, especially for anybody that may have issues running into people that are running the level 3 armor. I've noticed there's like a few guaranteed ways to get level 3 armor, one of which would be from the mystery box that spawns at the asylum and at the graveyard and at the diner. A lot of the time, level 3 armor will be in there. Like, I've noticed out of 10 or 11 mystery boxes I've jumped on and opened, there were like 8 or 9 level 3 armors in there throughout the course of opening up those mystery boxes. And they pop up quite frequently, especially if they're used and then they pass between the asylum and the graveyard. At that point, if you're staying there and you have full control of those areas, you can actually have your entire quad team loaded up with tier 3 armor. It is absolutely crazy, and I don't know the way that they can fix that specific aspect of it beyond making sure it doesn't spawn as often as it does in those mystery boxes. But then again, those are high contention areas. If you get the kills on the enemies, you deserve to get tier 3 armor from those mystery boxes. Maybe change the spawn rates of the mystery boxes. I have no idea how they're going to manage that. But tier 3 armor gets the benefit of added headshot protection, meaning you're not going to go down right away. And speaking of which, we're going to have to talk a little bit about sniper rifles. If you guys couldn't tell from the gameplays I've been uploading the past few days, I'm a huge fan of the snipers and how they work, and I love getting those long range shots and getting people who are driving quads or cargo trucks. It's something that I just find absolutely enjoyable. So they're actually changing the way that the snipers work. The Koshka and the Paladin 50 cal are both going to no longer one-shot players with 200 HP in the head. I find that quite fascinating that they're changing this. I think if you get a headshot, it should be a one shot, no matter what. A lot of the time when people snipe, they don't take into account bullet drop. So when you're shooting for the head, it drops to your chest and you don't get killed. I think if you're someone who can hone your skills and be able to snipe somebody from across the map, a one shot to the head is super acceptable, especially if you're playing in a mode where people can be revived. If you're playing solos, then okay, I can understand the frustration, but duos and quads definitely need to retain that one shot capability, especially for a sniper. They're powerful for a reason, and I think that that's unacceptable. I 100% wholeheartedly agree if you're wearing tier 3 armor and get shot in the head, it shouldn't be a one shot down. But if you don't have tier 3 armor, a one shot to the head should be a down. Instantaneously, you should go down or potentially get a kill if you're playing solos. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think about that down below in the comment section. Oh yeah, and on top of that, we got to take into consideration that the Kashka sniper rifle ended up getting a nerf. They changed the way that the aim down sight works, so you're not aiming down sight as quickly. It's definitely a huge issue, especially if you have a scope and you're in a close range engagement with somebody. Aiming down sights happens immediately in some cases, so I can definitely understand them tuning that, but the headshot thing, I don't know, man. That bugs me. That rubs me the wrong way. It's just like all those times where I played Modern Warfare 2 and I used the Barrett 50 cal, shot somebody directly in their fucking chest, and then I end up getting a hit marker. That pisses me off. And now that's gonna happen on somebody's fucking head. My... Just imagine the situations you're gonna get into where you see a helicopter and maybe you want to take a shot at that helicopter. Maybe you want to kill the pilot that's in there with the headshot. And guess what? If they're wearing tier 3 armor, good. I hope that I don't get a one-shot kill. But if they're not wearing armor, my fucking god, I better get clips like this.
I hear a helicopter. I see a helicopter.
No fucking way, dude! Holy shit!
That was on the dang...
Clip it! Clip it! But anyway, moving on, I want to talk a little bit about team killing, because there's been a lot of conversation on Reddit and, of course, at the Treyarch studio about potentially removing or changing team killing. So team killing, if you guys didn't know, you can kill your team when you're playing Blackout in duos or quads. And of course, this can be extremely annoying for many, many reasons. People like to grief. People like to kill people for no other reason than to just say, haha, I killed my whole team. Now let me join another game and do it again. What a sad, sad little man if you do that. Or woman, I'm not going to judge. Either way, here's my opinion on it. Team killing is something that I kind of expected to be in this game. At the same time, I don't like how specific things affect my team. So for example, if I throw a 9-bang or a flash grenade or a concussion or whatever, my team can be affected by that, and I can be affected by that. So I understand myself being affected by that, but my team being affected... That really sucks, especially for pushing a full team and I throw a 9-bang and I blind both of us. Then we're both in a bad situation, right? I don't really like that. The other thing I don't really like is if I throw a cluster grenade and say it goes off initially on the enemies and then my teammates run up to it and they get killed by the clusters that come off of it. That's really annoying because I'm damaging my team or I'm hurting them. Or if I'm shooting at an enemy and an unsuspecting teammate runs in the crossfire and they end up taking some damage or potentially getting downed, that's annoying. Or if I'm driving a vehicle and I end up tapping my teammate and they go down because of it, that's annoying. I don't really like team killing, I'll be honest with you, for more reasons than what I just explained. But I understand why it needs to be in this game. It would be cool to kind of see if they test it without team killing for a little while, just to like... do a day of, hey, there's no team killing in the game anymore. Just to put it out there, not a limited time mode, just change it all together and just see how people take it. I know a lot of people are going to enjoy it. I personally would enjoy it because just like a normal Call of Duty match, when I'm playing with my team and I throw a 9-bang, they don't normally get affected by that. They don't normally get affected by the explosions that I'm trying to, you know, save us from. So either way, let me know what you guys think about all of that down below in the comment section. I really hope you guys enjoyed this victory that we got here today. If you did, drop a like on the video. If you're new to my channel and if you're new to my commentaries, make sure to click that subscribe button down below. Don't forget to join the notification squad by clicking that little bell icon next to it and let YouTube notify you when my videos go live. I appreciate you guys coming out each and every day, and I will catch you guys on the next video. Peace.